Hello everyone and welcome back. A few days back I had published a video on 3D cube animation, and on that video Sanket Mehta commented and asked if we can create the same animation using the morph transition to save the time on the animation part, and maybe he also tried that and got successful. So I thought why not to tell you about this, that if we can make this same animation using the morph transition. So let's get started. And here we have another presentation where I have used the morph transition on 5 of the slides. So we did nothing much to create the same animation sequence. Let me show you once again the preview. And it is up to you that how you want to rotate these 3D cubes using the morph transitions. So let's get started. And here you can see in the animation pan that we have not applied a single animation effect to this presentation. And on the first slide, if I go to the transition tab, then you can see that we have not applied a transition to this first slide. But from the second to fifth slide, you can see that we have applied the morph transition. And you should also note one more thing, that what is the duration of this morph transition, that is 2 seconds. And when we are advancing to the next slide, after the duration of these 2 seconds end, then it will automatically get moved to the next slide. And we did the same on all of the rest of the slides. So here on the first slide, we have drawn 3 rectangles and 3 3D cubes. And now we want to make an animation of them using the morph transition. So what I will do, I will right click on this first slide and will choose duplicate slide. And on the second slide, I will apply the morph transition with the duration of 2 seconds. It is up to you that how much time you want to give. And then I want to advance to next slide without any further delay. So here on the second slide, what I want to do, I want to move this blue 3D cube right here and this blue 2D rectangle right at this point. And now I want to move this yellow one right here and this 3D yellow cube right at this point. These red guidelines shows you that if the alignment of both of these objects are equal. And now I want to move this red one right here and this red one right here. The next thing you can do, you can right click on these 3D objects and go to format 3D model. So now I want to give this red cube X rotation up to 90 degrees, and this yellow cube Y rotation 90 degrees, and this blue one X rotation 270 degrees. Now if I move to first slide and go to the slideshow, so that what we get using the 3D rotations. The link of this presentation is given in the video description. You can go and download this, and after opening the presentation you can note that after right clicking on the one of the 3D cube and go to format 3D model, here you can see that on what slides we have applied what kind of rotation to each of the cube. And it is totally up to you that how you want to rotate them while the morph transition happens. So let me show you the fourth slide, and here you can see and note down the rotations for each of the cube. And you can move these 2D rectangle easily at any position by holding the shift key. And that is the fifth slide. And let me show you the settings here for all the 3D cubes. So it was easy to create the same animation using the morph transition instead of PowerPoint animation effects. So I hope you will like this tutorial, and I would like to thank Sanket Mehta for advising us about this. And I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video, and do subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.